I'm Evelyn, and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all having an amazing day. So, today we are building what I would call a tiny house just because of how the living room plus the kitchen and also the dining area is laid out. I feel like tiny house, like the size of tiny house, does, or tiny houses, does depend a little bit on the amount of Sims you can put into the houses, and this house does actually have room for 4 Sims total, so 2 couples or just 2 single Sims. Unless they're really good friends and don't mind sharing bits, then you could fit in more Sims here, but I don't know, just me personally, I would want my own bed instead of sharing it with, you know, a friend. So I'd say 2 to 4 Sims, and there's also 1 bathroom, 1 kitchen, 1 living room, and you know, all the other stuff. So 2 bedrooms total, and yeah, that's why I see it as a tiny house, because it does have room for 4 Sims total, so, but it depends a little bit, you know, different opinions and all that stuff. But yeah, anyways, so it's just for 2 roommates and, or 4 roommates, I suppose, 2 couples being roommates or something. But I was just really in the mood to build something smaller, a little bit more cramped together, and this is basically what I ended up building. So yeah, I hope you guys like it. I do already have a build ready for tomorrow. I just need to do the voiceover and take the pictures, edit them, and all that other stuff. But the build and editing part is over, so it's mainly done, or it's almost done. So that should be coming up as well. It's a bit of a bigger one. It's built on a 40 by 30. I hope you guys are looking forward to that build. And then I am counting on being able to decorate an apartment for Friday, possibly. But we will see about that one. I might be building a house instead, but it's not all set in stone, but there should be plenty of videos up for the rest of the week, I hope, because we've had a bit of a situation here at home. I did talk about it very briefly over on Twitter. I've also mentioned it on my Discord server, but the boiler has been broken. It's not that I'm gonna sit here and rant about it, by the way, but it's just like a little side note or something. The boiler here at home has been broken for, I don't, 1.5 or 2 weeks. I haven't had a warm shower for the same amount of time, and it's slightly driving me crazy, to be honest. So the boiler guy was supposed to come here and fix it today, and me and my partner have been home all day just waiting for the guy to come and fix it, and then he wrote a 4 that he wasn't going to make it until Friday. So, ugh, it's just, why? Why couldn't you write a little bit earlier? So yeah, I have to wait another couple of days before I can finally have a proper, nice, hot shower. Oh my god, I miss hot showers so much. I don't know if it's got something to do with me being ginger, because I have read that ginger people or redheaded people do have thinner skin than the average person, but I don't know if that's correct. It could just be some sort of bogus article that I've read about it. But I do feel pain with cold water, and I also feel like, we're not even talking like cold water, but just regular, let's say, fridge temperature water, or maybe a little bit warmer than that. It actually hurts me. And the same counts for like really warm water. Obviously, it does hurt a lot of people, I know that, but it's just like, I don't know what it is. I'm really sensitive to temperatures, basically, so it's been painful to shower in the cold water, and I just want the boiler to work. So anyways, yeah, that's what's been going on today. It's very exciting. I know, super interesting to listen to, but I don't know. I just felt like sharing my slightly frustrating day with you guys. So there you go. You are welcome. Anyways, so for the interior in this house, I was inspired by the exterior, where I used a lot of white and also this sort of like medium, slightly warmer brown, and I really like those two colors together. Or white is not really a color, but I do like white with the sort of medium brown color. It looks really nice, in my opinion. It kind of reminds me of chocolate, like a white chocolate, milk chocolate kind of swirl or something. I don't know what it is. Apparently I'm thinking about chocolate. I really shouldn't be thinking about chocolate though, because it's really unhealthy. But anyways, moving on. So we are using the floorboards, as you can see, that are from Island Living. I've been using these quite a lot lately, and I don't know, I just really like the textures on them. I wish this one had a bit more swatches, because the other one that we got with Island Living definitely has a lot more, and it would have been nice to just have a bit more colors to choose between, a bit more choices, but it's fine. I still like the texture on this floor. So yeah, but other than that, I'm basically just going for a mix of furniture from the different packs. I'm not really sticking to any three packs in particular. I did forget to clutter up the kitchen here, by the way. I go back at the very end of the video because I realized before I started taking screenshots, I was like, I feel like I was missing something somewhere in the kitchen or the living room. So I do go back and fix that later on. Don't worry, we won't just have two completely empty shelves there. That looks a little bit weird in my opinion. But I don't know what I would call this sort of interior. It's slightly industrial, but it's also sort of mid-century modern. I have used a coffee table that's definitely mid-century modern. Also, the two dining chairs are mid-century modern. But, oh yeah, also a bed in the other bedroom, actually. That one is from Get Famous. This one that I'm using right here is from Seasons. I've been accused of using CC for using that bed before, but it's very much from Seasons. It's one of my favorite beds. I just love the throw on it. It looks so nice. I really like the texture on it. Oh, by the way, in here, I actually decided to add a pop of red here and there because I've used one of the chairs that came with City Living and it had this really nice, very rich red swatch and I just had to go for it. Something was telling me that I just had to go for it. So I decided to turn a few items here. I think I was slightly inspired by the bookcase that I ended up using over here too, because that one is from Base Game, but it's like this sort of light brown and then it has a red trim on it. So I had to tie in the red with something else. And then I saw the swatch on the chair and I was like, something just like a light bulb just turned on or something. And I was like, yes, we're going for this. We're adding just a little bit of red. And I really like how it looks. Just like a little bit on the bedside table, there is the plant over in the corner, and then the chair and the bookcase. Just a little bit of red here and there, it looked really nice. So, but other than that, I think we're just going for a few browns and also black and white in here, so. As we're getting closer to Realm of Magic, by the way, I do think that I will be doing a few more smaller builds this upcoming week just to make sure that I can spend all my time focusing on the new pack once I get access to it. So those of you who do prefer smaller builds might be happy about that, and those of you who don't worry, I will be returning with more bigger builds eventually. It's just, or the week after. It's just bigger builds do take a lot longer to both build, obviously, but also turn into videos. So it's just, I don't know, sometimes it's a little bit funnier to stick to smaller builds because you get to experience or play around with different styles instead of just sticking to one style for many, 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 many hours. But there's a bigger house coming up tomorrow, like I said before, and I'm also planning on doing one for either, is it Saturday, I think, or possibly the start of next week. But then after that, just smaller builds, I think, and possibly also some apartments. If there are any specific apartment themes you want me to go for, by the way, please let me know because I'm all up for suggestions for that. I don't have any apartments left to do other than towny apartments for the save file. So other than that, I am just building whatever or decorating whatever that I feel like decorating in the moment. So if you got any ideas, definitely let me know. So we moved on to the second bedroom, and I'll admit I didn't really know where to go with this bedroom. So it does look a little bit like a mess here at the start, but I feel like it turned out fine afterwards. And I don't think I've ever used that wardrobe, by the way, but I felt like since they had a clothing rack in here and there's not a whole lot of clothes on that thing, they kind of needed somewhere else to also have clothes stored. So I had to put a wardrobe in there or a dresser, but unfortunately there's not a whole lot of room for a dresser in here, so I went with the wardrobe. And yeah, I don't think I've ever used it before. I think it's Base Game actually, and I don't know, it's very simple, but it's a little bit weird because it's kind of like, it's wider at the top and then narrow at the bottom, and I don't know why they made it like that. If they just made it like a proper rectangle, it could totally look like an IKEA wardrobe, but they didn't do that, and I find it a little bit weird. I find it a little bit strange, but I do like it. I just don't ever use it. And yeah, other than that, you saw we're just going for a few blues in there, and it's a very simple room. I do love the new clothing rack that came with Moschino stuff pack. I said this with in the first video I did with the pack, I think, or was it the second? I don't remember. Anyways, but I really want a clothing rack in real life. I love having clothes on display. I don't know what it is, plus it gets dusty and stuff, but I just like having it on display. So I really want a clothing rack in real life, but I don't have any room for it right now, but it looks really, really nice. I just really like them, so. But I think that's about it for the interior, actually. I'm spending a little bit extra time on the exterior because I didn't know what to do exactly for the backyard. We don't have a lot of space to deal with in the back, by the way. So I do end up giving them a very small pool over by the corner of the backyard. And then they also have the barbecue area that you saw before. And I also used some lounge chairs in the backyard too. So they have a little bit of a nice, like, relaxing area in the backyard. I will admit, I did consider for a second to just not do anything because I felt like maybe these roommates were not completely into the outdoors kind of life. Like, maybe they didn't care too much about the backyard, but I had to do something. So I decided to give them the pool, and hopefully they'll enjoy the pool. And if not, then that's also completely fine. You can just delete it and maybe put something else there instead. But yeah, I will say, like, having a small pool on good summer days would be pretty nice. And something I'm struggling a little bit when I'm using the new foundations here with the stilts, or yeah, would you call them that? Like stilts? I hope we're just gonna go with that. When I'm using that foundation, I really want to not put too much landscaping in front of the foundation, because then you can't actually see that it's on stilts. So I struggle a little bit with that when I use this foundation, but I feel like I kept a few areas empty so you can still see the stilts. And yeah, that one came, or those two foundations actually came with the update before we got Island Living, so you should have those in your game if you have updated your game since June, I think. So yeah, but they're pretty nice. They're fun to play around with and stuff. But here you can see the backyard that I talked about just before with the little pool over in the corner. And also I did frame up this little area over in the other corner, so they just had to have a little bit of, like, a little bit of greenery here other than just the hedges. So I do go back and copy paste some of the plants that I'm using at the front of the house and then put them here in the backyard just to make it a little bit more coherent. But I didn't want it to take up too much space, so I framed in this little area over by the corner and then put the lounge chairs in front. So your Sims can sit there and sunbathe if they want to. At least I think they should be able to sunbathe outside of Sulani. I'll admit I have not play tested it because sunbathing is not really something that I think about too much, so I kind of forget that the Sims can sunbathe in the game. I'll admit I played a bit with it when Island Living just came out because I thought that tan lines were really fun to look at, but I just kind of forgotten about it since then. Obviously, as a ginger person, yes, the second time that I'm mentioning it in this video, but I don't think about sunbathing ever because I burn. So I kind of forget that my Sims can do it, but they should be able to do it in other worlds and not just Sulani, right? But correct me if I'm wrong. But yeah, other than that, I think we're just finishing up a few things here and or around the build, adding a few more plants and also fixing the clutter problem in the kitchen, and that should be about it. So if you guys like this house, you can download it off the gallery. My ID is EvelynYT, and you could also find it under the hashtag Evelyn or EvelynYT. And like I said earlier in the video, if you got any suggestions for any apartment builds you want to see, definitely let me know. I will also be doing a few of the suggestions that I got over on the community tab. Hopefully Saturday's build should be one of those suggestions, I hope. But still do let me know about apartments if you got any themes you want me to go for or give a try. And yeah, other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Remember to like and subscribe and all that good stuff if you did. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye!